happened in 66 AD. The big rebellion of the Jews started against the Romans. But it started far away from here in the Galilee. It took 4 years for the Romans to fight against the Zealots, the freedom fighters, in the Galilee in the year 70. I hope you remember this day. Jerusalem was destroyed, the temple was destroyed. And actually, the story of Masada that you heard in the movie is a story of 3 years only, between the year 70 to the year 73. 968 people escaped from Jerusalem, came at night, but had climbed the snake path, surprised the Romans, and captured the flags and were here for 3 years. Assuming that a third of them were women and a third children, we talk about 300 fighters. Now what can 300 fighters do against the big Roman Empire? Probably nothing. But the Romans were afraid that this will be a nest of another revolution. And against these 300 fighters, they sent an army of 10,000 soldiers that came together with another 10,000 Jewish prisoners of war that they took as prisoners of war in Jerusalem. These 20,000 came here and they were sure that it would be very easy to capture. But you can see how narrow is the snake path. Even if you have a million soldiers behind you, only two can form the front line. Time, bow and arrows, spears, big boulders that they rolled down on the head of the enemy, boiling water and boiling oil that they threw on the head of the enemy. So after a few attempts to capture, the Romans understood it's not going to be so easy. They decided to change the tactic and they built 8 Roman camps. I will show you remains of 5 of them, connected them with a wall, and nobody was able to go out and bring supply. But because of 15 storerooms that we will see that were full of food, and because all that area past the green flag is a farm, used to be a farm, they had enough food, and because of the clever water system, more than enough water. Josephus Flavius, the historian, wrote in his book that in order to tease the Romans, they used to wash their clothes and put it on the wall to dry. And of course, if the Romans saw that you have enough water for laundry, no doubt you are not thirsty. Now, after a year of the siege, the Romans understood that they will not be able to defeat them this way. Again, they changed the tactic. On the other side of Masada, there is a deep valley, and next to it, a sandy hill. They ordered the Jewish slaves to move the hill towards Masada. They gave them buckets, and day and night, they had to move more and more sand and build a ramp that is visible till today. When the ramp reached almost the top, they built a wooden tower, and from the top of the wooden tower, as you can see in the movie, started to knock the wall. When they destroyed the first wall, they saw another wall in front of them. You see, the wall was double wall, as you can see here. When they destroyed the second wall, the people ran out of stones and built another barrier out of wood. When they saw the wooden wall, they set it in fire. In that point, Elazar, the son of Yair, this is the name of the commander, the Jewish commander up here, understood that he will not be able to stop the Romans. He gathered his people and gave them his last speech. No doubt he was an excellent speaker. At the beginning he told them that normally human beings are born free, and normally you die as a free person. And then he described what terrible way of life they will have in case they will fall alive to the hands of the Romans. He told the men that they will be slaves for the rest of their life. He told them that the Romans will tie their hands behind their back. They will hear how their kids are crying, "Daddy, help us," and they will not be able to help. They will see how the Romans abuse their daughters and wives, and they will not be able to stop it. Picturing such a terrible picture, he brought them to the decision. And he told them that in his opinion, the only way to live this world in freedom and dignity is to commit a suicide. The terrible task was given to every head of a family. I don't think that this was mentioned in the movie. Every head of the family had to kill his own family by slaughtering. Then they made lots. Who will be the last 10 and who will be the last one among the 10 that will have to kill each other and commit a suicide? Only 2 women and 3 children were afraid to do it. They escaped to a cave up here, but they saw what happened here. And they told it to Josephus Flavius, and that's how we know about it. But because we have only one source of information about what happened here, and this is the book of Josephus Flavius, and by the way, you can buy a translation of it in English, estimations here, we found out that we can trust the testimony of Josephus Flavius. We call him the master of details. Everything he described in his book was found. The exact number of watchtowers, the exact size of Masada, including what Professor Netzer told you in the movie, 10 pieces of clay with 10 Jewish names. Even the lots the last 10 did were found. So we don't see any reason to doubt.